Welcome back. Hope you're enjoying the program. Coming up next is the Afri Tour program with Rahel Ifu, and she's going to take us to the beautiful country, Kenya. Greetings and welcome back to your weekly Afri Tour program. I'm Rahel Ifu. Afri Tour program taking its dear viewers to the African country's best tourism destinations and heritage sites. Today, we're flying to the beautiful Kenya and explore its best tourist destinations. Kenya means God's resting place. The country is known for its spectacular beauty and the visit offers the experience of a lifetime. Kenya has 7 sites registered by the UNESCO World Heritage Site, categorized by cultural and natural. Let's see them one by one.
Kenya is a country having different tourist destinations. Kenya means God's resting place. The country is known for its spectacular beauty and the visit offers the experience of a lifetime. It is renowned worldwide as a preferred tourism attraction for its amazing sites and unmatched hospitality of its people. In addition to that, Kenya has 7 sites registered by the UNESCO World Heritage, categorized by cultural and natural. And today, by our Afri Top Afri Tour program first edition, we will shortly see this site in order to partially show the vast tourism potential of Kenya. Kenya's cultural site registered by UNESCO, let's see them one by one. The first one is Lamu Old Town. The Lamu Old Town is considered as the best preserved and oldest Swahili settlement in the coastal stripe of East Africa. This town has been continually inhabited for 7 centuries. Even today, this town still has some of Kenya's most conservative societies. Lamu Old Town serves as the cradle of civilization for the Swahili people. This is commemorated through the many cultural festivals and Islamic celebrations in the town. In 2001, it was added to the list of UNESCO World Heritage Site in Kenya. The next one would be Forest Jesus, Mombasa. This fort is one of the cultural UNESCO World Sites in Kenya. It was inscribed into the list in 2011 as this 16th century fort was designed to guard the old port of Mombasa. This fort is the only one that is maintained by the Portuguese in the Swahili coast. Hence, it's also a symbol of how Western power successfully established their influence on the trading activity in the Indian Ocean. The architecture of the forest itself was important to the cultural heritage of the site. Aside from showcasing Renaissance architectural site, the labor, materials and masonry technologies are inspired by the local Swahili people. Meanwhile, the fort is considered as one of the best military forts during the late Renaissance of era. Sri is the Skard Mijikenda Kaya Forest. The Skard Mijikenda Kaya Forest in Kenya is another entry to the list of UNESCO World Heritage Site in Kenya. It's composed of 11 forest sites that are located along the coast of fortified village by the Mijikenda people. These villages are locally known as the Kaya. These villages are formed in the 16th century. But by 1940s, the village had been left in an abandoned state. They are then regarded as scarred sites and are still being maintained by a council of elders. Due to its unique testimony to a rich culture and tradition in Kenya, it earned a spot in the UNESCO list in 2008. Our final cultural site will be Timiling Oonga Cultural Landscape, which is archaeological site. Among the outstanding but least noticed tourism destinations is the Timiling Oonga stone enclosure in Migori, which has been described as an architectural masterpiece. It was promoted as a natural monument in 1982 and added to the UNESCO World Heritage Site in 2018, located northwest of the town of Migori in Lake Victoria region. This dry stone walled settlement was probably built in the 16th century. The settlement seems to have served as a fort for communities and livestock, but also defined social entities and relationships like to lineage. The site covers the indigenous forest, which is also a home for more than 300 monkeys and lots of bird species with very rich biodiversity. Kenya's natural site registered by the UNESCO. One by one, the Kenya natural site registered by UNESCO. The first one is Kenya Lake System in the Great Rift Valley. The Kenya Lake System in the Great Rift Valley is the first natural site in the list of UNESCO World Heritage Site in Kenya, listed in 2011. It is a natural landscape consisting of three lake basins that are located at the valley floor. This site is noted for its rich population of migratory birds, great white pelicans, and lesser flamingo. The three lakes that are encompassed in this lake system are Lake Elementai, Lake Nakuru, and Lake Bogoria. These lakes are hydrogeologically connected to each other through subsurface seepage of water. The alkaline from these lakes supports the algae formation that are served as food for the flamingos. Our second natural site will be Lake Turkana Natural Park. This natural site composed three national parks within Kenya's Lake Turkana. Inscribed into the list of UNESCO World Heritage Site in Kenya, the coverage of the site was expanded in 2001. This site is considered important as a stopping point for migratory birds, as well as the breeding ground for various species of reptiles, including snakes, hippopotamus, and Nile crocodile. The main components of this park are Sibilio National Park, Lake Turkana, and Central Iceland. In addition to being a breeding ground and stopping point for migratory birds, it is also home to copepod fossil deposits. Our third natural heritage site will be Mount Kenyan National Park, National Forest, which is a national forest. This national park and forest were founded in 1949 and added to the list of UNESCO World Heritage Site in Kenya in 1997. The aim for the establishment of this national park was to protect Mount Kenya along with its wildlife environment. This natural environment is crucial as a natural habitat for the animal species that live in the area. Furthermore, it acts as a water catchment area that provides water supply to all of Kenya. It's also a UNESCO Biosphere Reserve. In fact, this site was primarily a forest reserve before it was elevated into the status of a national park.
Welcome back. I hope you have enjoyed and learned the main features of the heritage sites. And planning your next trip to Kenya as soon as we are over with the current COVID-19 pandemic. We would like to appreciate the Kenyan Embassy in Addis Ababa for the cooperation in preparing this program. And this is what we have for today. Till next week, Ka Salama. Stay safe.
Dear viewers, AfriTop Tourism Unimpaired Project envisions and is working in promoting and marketing Ethiopian and African tourism as tourism for commonwealth and prosperity and tourism for peace and unity. We would like to thank Eliana Grand Hotel for their lovely collaboration with us in preparing this program. We will see you next week with more interesting holiday programs. Don't miss it. Until then, have a good week.